हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द अनदर वीडियो ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ आरसीए एजुकेशन हब बानसूर। सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू क्लास 12th बायोलॉजी चैप्टर नंबर 9 एंजाइम्स। ओके, सो टुडे लेट डिस्कस अबाउट द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग एंजाइम एक्शन, ओके, और एंजाइम एक्टिविटी। सो हेयर सम फैक्टर्स आर गिवन हाउ दे कैन अफेक्ट द एक्टिविटी ऑफ एंजाइम, लेट्स डिस्कस। So the first one is temperature. Enzymes are highly sensitive to the temperature as they are proteinaceous in nature, or as they are consist of proteins. Okay, they perform their optimum activity at the range of 20 degree to 35 degree temperature. Is that clear? Beyond that, if temperature increases, that causes denaturization of the enzyme. Understand? But in this range, if 10 degrees Celsius of temperature increases, then it enhances the enzyme activity about 2.5 times. Okay, so overall temperature can affect the enzyme activity, okay, because they are proteinaceous in nature, and that temperature at which enzyme perform their optimum activity, that is from 20 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. During this range, if 10 degree of temperature increases, then it enhances the enzyme activity about 2.5 times. Okay, but beyond that, increase in the temperature causes denaturization of the enzyme. It means they lost their enzymatic activity. Okay, they lost their enzymatic activity. The another factor which affect the enzyme activity, pH range. So enzymes are sensitive for the pH 2, and they perform their optimum activity at the range of 5 to 7.5 pH. Okay, so this is a specific pH range for the enzymatic activities. Beyond that or below that, reduce the enzymatic activities. The next one is substrate concentration. Yes, substrate concentration also have an impact on the enzymatic activities. How? So if the substrate are minimum, okay, if the minimum concentration of the substrate are there, then they decrease the enzymatic activity also, because enzymes are present but substrate are not present there for binding with the enzymes. So minimum concentration, it means the enzyme activity also get reduced. Second one is optimum concentration of enzyme substrate. Optimum concentration of substrate can enhance the enzymatic activity also, and enzyme can also perform at their optimum rate. Okay, they perform at their optimum rate. How? Because how much enzymes are there? Same number of substrate are present. So they directly enhance the rate of enzymatic activity. And the third one is maximum concentration. So maximum concentration of the substrate can also reduce the enzymatic activity. How? Because their substrate are present in large amount, but enzymes are not. Okay, if not enzymes are there, then how they can bind with the substrate? If they do not bind with the substrate, how they can proceed the reaction? Okay, so here the main thing is that optimum concentration of the substrate can enhance or can reach the optimum rate of the enzymatic activity, and this is known as maximum efficiency of the enzymes. Okay, the next one is end product or the concentration of end products. So in a one or another way, end products also affect the activity of the enzymes. How? For example, here all the enzymes combined with the substrate and they are forming the end products. But if end products can accumulate, okay, and they are increasing number, then after establishment of the equilibrium, these substrate having a reciprocal effect on the enzyme activity, and they reduce the enzyme activity. Okay, they reduce the enzyme activity. It means the end product is accumulated. It cannot be utilized. There is no use of the end products.